What's up, everybody? Can you still hear me?
Hello, hello.
All right. Anthony, can you just tell me if you can still hear this when I go outside?
Okay, thank you.
I wanted to see if you could hear me on there real quick. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Yes.
You can still hear me. Okay. Oh, you put on me. What's up, everybody? This is Simply Dot Tamita. I don't know if you're going to be able to hear my family, but I'm going to definitely move away from that computer. I wanted to do some different things today, so I just wanted to holler at y'all for just a little bit. Welcome, welcome, welcome for anybody who has not participated with I'm Just Saying Live ever. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show, okay? Now, this is one of them shows where you don't always see something different. You never know what's going to be going on. And today, you know, because there is so, when I say so much going on out here in LVC, like they used to say back in the day on the game, I mean, on a song, I feel like we needed another one of my little I'm Just Saying chats. So if y'all down with that, I want y'all to stick right here. I want y'all to pay a lot of attention, okay? Because I'm going to just do that. Over the course of the weekend, you guys, well, not even the weekend, we left on last Wednesday, and my family and I took a little trip, and I'm going to take y'all on my walk today. I like to walk around the neighborhood. My family and I took a trip, because I always like to start with the weekend recap. This weekend got extra, extra long, okay? When I say extra long, I mean extra long. I'm gonna check in the comments, and I need all my drivers right now. I need every single driver I got out there who has tried to take their family on a trip with them in the big rig, in the dually, in whatever. I need y'all to log on right now. I need you to post down in the comments on Facebook Live how your trip went. We did a trip of the Great Plains, okay? So that means we left Texas. We went through Oklahoma. We went through Kansas. We then went on to Nebraska,
then to South Dakota, then to North Dakota, okay? And that's where we decided to, you know, stop or whatever for our trip. We did the, you know, went all the way up the Great Plains so the kids could see how plain it was, if you will. And that's what went on. We had a really, really good time, but this ELD situation, and I'm about to talk like a real live driver real quick, okay? It's about to get real serious. I'm gonna just pop a squat right here. Just because that's what I want to do. I hope y'all can still see my face. Listen, the ELD that's in there supervising these drivers, so stressful. She telling you stuff to do all day, nonstop. Move here, move there, go left, go right. So while we're on this trip, and I'm going to show you guys some pictures, if it'll allow me to share my screen, from our different states that we popped out to. But, she was stressing me out, y'all. I've been out here cutting the yard. I know y'all looking at like, why she got this bonnet on today? But I wanted to go and hang out with my family because with all the stuff going on, especially with the Uvalde school shooting, I just really, really, you know, wanted to, you know, kind of love on my family for a little bit. And so I was like, well, let me try to do the right thing and I'm gonna support him and I'm going this ride. Lord Jesus, it was so long and hard, and I was spending up so much money between the hotels and trying to find some good food. I had to eat gas station food. I don't eat gas station food, okay? And I was having to eat gas station food because the supervisor, this ELD, tells you where to stop, when to stop, how to stop, how long to stop, all of this. So while I'm in there, I didn't have a choice. You know, we brought a cooler of food, and I just want to know how y'all did it and how you planned it. You know, that's a different circle that, you know, I kind of haven't reached out to. It's the drivers out there, but we are definitely a trucking family. We've been doing this since 2008. I know y'all hear me say J&T Williams Transportation is sponsoring things, or J&T Transportation. And that's what we do, man. That's what we do to really make our money. And I know everybody has these different side hustles and things like that, but what are some of your barriers? Because I felt like it made the trip take entirely too long. I thought we were going to pop up there and we were going to pop back. If I would have brought the boys' passports, I most likely would have not only done that, but also going into Canada. We probably would have gone into Canada just so they could see, because they've never been up there. So how do y'all plan for, you know, a road trip nowadays? Now that there's planes and everything else, we can get there so much faster. You know, we did also think about doing a train trip where you go on the train for several days. Tell me how you plan a road trip, an actual vehicle road trip. And I want you, bring me my computer, please. I just want to know how you guys planned it. And that's Mr. Thomas, you know, call me aunt. He always up to his shenanigans. He definitely was not ready this morning, but it's okay, because we thought about kind of canceling and not doing anything at all. But I just had to get on here and say, you know, that I thought that was hilarious. I want to see how all of you guys go with your, you know, with your family trips and things like that. So let me see this real quick. See my screen. Oh, let's see. Never mind. That's not going to work. Okay, so I'm going to sit right here till he brings that out here. But we had a lot of fun. We did visit the zoo. There's not very much to do in North Dakota. You know, I'm always talking about you guys being able to live vicariously through me. So I'm definitely going to be making a reel about this trip. We went up there, went to the zoo, we went and got put out of a restaurant because it was 21 and up, even though we were, you know, with our family or whatever. So I don't know. I don't need that, baby. Thank you. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I don't know what to say about that. This is Jeremiah, everybody. He's visiting from Colorado right now. You know, I always have tons and tons of kids over the summertime. So that's another thing when we talk about kids. I want to tell you guys, annual underwear affairs giveaway is coming up, okay? I need you guys to either sponsor the event I'll put your logo on the flyer. When I'm sending it out to all these people doing all this different stuff, you will be included all the way through. We are just now kind of gearing up for this year's giveaway, which is going to be July the 23rd. It's going to be at Finnegan Park because, of course, we're going to go to the community that kind of raised up Big Daddy, and we're going to do it like that. I want you guys to be a part of this. I want you to come out. I want you to volunteer. I want you to be able to get your kids involved. I want you to get your kids involved. Please, please, please. Look, look, they're all over here working, trying to get me set up in the robes. And I said that I didn't want anything structured. I was just chilling today. And you out here doing the most. He's always doing the most, okay? But I know, baby, I know. It's your daddy. But anyway, yeah, so again, I want to go back to family in the truck. Post your comments right now. How do you do it? How do you make it work for your fam? Period. Okay, I'm about to click him in here real quick. I don't know if he put this right. Oh, goodness, goodness, goodness. All right, there, all right, there, all right, there, all right, there.
You need this?
You say what? All right, guys, there we are.
Good morning, America. I hear you talking about the truck drivers out there.
Definitely talking about the truck drivers. Definitely talking about the truck drivers. And I'm going to pop up a Facebook real quick so I can see if anybody made a comment. I just don't know. Anthony, how did you like the trip in the truck with your family?
Oh, the trip was fine. But that new ELD, electronic learning device, is straight from hell.
That is like the worst supervisor you could ever possibly have.
Let me get in here so y'all can hear me and see me when I tell you this. They designed the ELD for you 18-wheeler drivers that want to drive 40 hours straight without taking a rest. Y'all out here running people off the road and sleeping and driving at the same time. It's not for us hotshot drivers, but we
who out there sleeping and driving at the same time?
Not when you got a co-pilot.
Oh, I'm not going to let you sleep. Every time I hear the brrrr, I'm like, wait, what's going on?
There's nobody veering off the road over here.
Yes, you are. He likes to veer. He like to be looking at things. He ain't got no business. There's
a lot of animals out there to look at.
Yeah, whatever.
Different type of deers, different size, armadillos, all that, everything. But yeah, so they didn't design this for the hotshot drivers or the smaller transportation drivers. But we fought it for like four or five years. Then this year they made it mandated that we had to put the electronic logging device in our truck. Well, we can't make the money that we used to because now we can only drive for 8 hours straight, stop for 30 minutes, and then drive the remaining 3 hours. So technically we only got 11 hours to drive. And then we got to shut down for 10 hours. Man, that's horrible. You know, I can run out to Colorado and turn around and come all the way back in that amount of time, but now we can't. So now my money done got cut short. So now I got to figure out something else. What else I need to do? But man, when I say that thing kills your time and kills your money, not to throw in the gas prices that's out here now. We was up in North Dakota, the gas was $6.25 or 50 cents a gallon.
That part.
I said, I'll wait till we get back to Texas, get me some fuel.
Well, clearly what I'm going to do right now is I'm about to share this link because I got tons of kids here in the house. I need you guys to take time, share this link to any driver that you know out there. You got your phone?
Okay, I'll go get it.
Okay, because I'm going to send you the link as well.
I'm going to send it to the big truck drivers out there.
I need to send it to all the big truck drivers. We're checking in for the fam bam today in regards to the big truck drivers. But while I'm doing that, I wanted to talk to you guys about the situation that happened and some things that I think that you guys may not know in regards to what happened out in Uvalde. I told you last week that I really didn't understand, you know, what was going on because they were making a lot of reports about the, what is it, the police not responding fast enough. So now tons of information is out, and we keep hearing about how these police officers just basically did not respond in the way that they would, especially if it was an African American that was in there gunning people down. And now we have all these parents who are dealing with the grief of losing their children. And I know that everybody's dealing with this. What is the return to school going to be like next year? You know, Biden has even chimed in when it comes to this massacre, if you will, and said that they're going to redo the school. I wanted to know, did you guys know that there is a complete grant program for school shootings? There's a grant program for school shootings in the U.S., and they knocked the school down and rebuilt it. Do you think that that's going to help the mental state of these families who've lost, some of them, their only child at this point? Do you think that that's going to help them? Anthony, right now, since you're chiming back in, and anybody who's just tuning in to I'm Just Saying Live, we're talking about the school shooting and what went on.
Uvalde.
Yes, and the grant program that's out there for school shootings. Like,
the rebuilding of the
school. Is it that many school shootings going on?
Oh, yes. They said in the course of that week, it was like 14 different school shootings throughout the United States. And, well, not school shootings, I'm sorry. Shootings within that week, 14 different shootings. And 90% of them had to do with teenagers or younger kids getting shot or whatever. Club scenes or people shooting in the neighborhood, but a lot of youngsters, a lot of kids died. And they trying to blame it on the guns. It's not the guns, it's the people that's purchasing the
right
guns.
So in the way of gun control, how do you fix that? Because I don't think you can fix that. I think it has to do with the mental state of the person at any given time. Is that something that we can fix?
Well, we can fix it because first and foremost, it starts at home. So if you have a gun or you know your kids like to partake in gun games, why not teach them about gun safety?
Correct. I think that is another part of gun safety, but clearly this young man knew how to use a gun. So
use
I don't
it
think
and
he was worried about anybody coming back. I think it really had to do with his mental state at the time. And, you know, we talked about this all month long last month, but clearly it's not a topic that needs to go anywhere anytime soon.
Well, okay, so we're going to say he had a mental health issue or a mental issue. But at the same time, if you are the parent and you're paying attention to your child, you know if your child is ready to be partaking in, you know, shooting targets or going out here hunting, shooting deer, squirrels, rabbits.
You can also tell if you're, you know, when they say, you know, kids who like to abuse animals and things of this nature, there are so many signs, ladies and gentlemen, that are out there that can tell you when your child is, you know, going the wrong route when it comes to weapons, if you will. And again, when it's time to return to school in the fall, mm-hmm. how are you parents, responding to this? I'm surprised there's not more people starting to go to homeschooling. I'm surprised there's not more people going to flood the private school system. Where do we go from here? How do you react to that? How do you send your kid back to school, and how do you train your child for a situation like this? That's going to be the next thing. Who's going to start training these kids? Who people can't afford that. You know, they can't not go to work.
So, but yeah, it's what they say, it's a dilemma, a pickle. I mean, it's hard. It's a hard decision because the parents got to go to work. So they probably can't homeschool. And a lot of parents are single parents trying to raise these children. And they probably don't have the time or not taking the time to try to partake in what their child is doing or ask them, how was their day? What you been doing lately? Because they say that these kids getting bullied, cyberbullying, bullying in school or whatever, and make these kids want to go off.
So remember that we know that it's a tough decision for a lot of people out here. Like I said, when things like this happen, there's grant money out there. I think that this grant money should not only go to rebuilding a school, if you will, because that's not looking at the same thing is not going to change.
Yeah, rebuilding.
I think
school?
That you need to. That's not going. I don't think that that's going to help at all. I think that there needs to be something in the way of mental support for these people. These people who have lost their children, for the kids that are remaining who had to see all of this, the ones that were calling 911. They've seen these funerals of their best friends, you know.
It's sad.
And they feel, you know, some of these kids feel like the police didn't come to their rescue because they were calling.
Yeah, one of the
and things still didn't happen.
One of the kids said they heard the cops in the hallway and they were yelling, telling the cop that I'm in here. But the cops didn't actually come all the way in the building. They were just at the doorway. Mm-hmm. And so now, how are these children gonna look at police protection? Are the cops here to protect us, or as they say, to serve and protect? Yeah, it's a hard thing for a child to deal with, let alone a parent losing a child and their respect for the law enforcement that wouldn't go in and try to, you know, save these kids. So it's very hard. And being a parent, you should understand.
Yeah, definitely. We're coming to you as parents right now. We want you guys to start thinking about the hard questions, the solutions that come along with this. Get involved some type of way. We're going to try to figure some things out in regards to getting involved and maybe helping out. And I just don't know where you would even start with that. There is no replacement for a parent losing their child. This has got to stop. Over the weekend, there were over a dozen other mass shootings. One was in Tennessee. They lost a lot of people there. All kinds of stuff is going on.
Yeah.
You know, I was proud of LeBron while we're talking about schools. He got out to his school this weekend and they were posting the pictures Again, if you're just tuning in, I'm just saying, we talk about all the current events. This is not normally how we do the show. We're going to just be real rigid. We're just going to talk about, you know, what we want to talk about today. And we're going to do it like that. Because this is, I'm just saying live and I can do what I want to. And I hope y'all enjoy it. And post your comments below. And we'll make sure that if you have a topic that you want to talk about today, you can hear Tanil's opinion. You can hear Call Me Aunt's opinion. Remember that you can follow both of us on Instagram. I am simply.tanil and
Call Me _Aunt.
All right. Okay. So here we go. Oh, thanks, Marvin. Thanks for coming on. Also, hey, Aunt Alice. It is also, you know, when he came out to the school, I saw him post up with the kids. You know, he provides scholarships for these kids to go to college. Most of these kids, if they can just stick it out in the school, you going to college. Like, yes. I think that is so amazing that he does that. Let's also talk about this now that Aunt Alice is on there. Family reunion time. So, ladies and gentlemen, we have not only talked about truck drivers and their families today, you know, trying to get out there on the roads, taking these road trips, making it happen for the family, loving on your family. We've talked about Uvalde school shooting and the things that went on with that, but it's family reunion season. Father's Day is coming up, reunions are coming up. And I just want to shout out to all the people out there who are on the planning committee for your family reunion.
Do your part.
There are so many things that come up when you're planning a family reunion, between the t-shirt orders at the last minute, between, you know,
who preparing the food,
who bringing the food, you know.
No, wait.
Who got the most money to buy the food?
Who bringing the chicken?
Black family reunions are definitely fun. You know, I haven't been to a white family reunion because I don't have, you know, that going on, but I wonder if they have just as much drama getting it together. Drama.
It's entertainment.
It's definitely entertainment.
It's very entertaining.
And what do you do at your family reunion? What is the most memorable moment that you've had at your family reunion?
It used to be my cousin Robert. My cousin Trisha husband.
What's up, CNT? Okay.
Ooh, when cousin Robert used to come, he used to be dressed in all white, like he like Frankie Beverly from Maze.
Okay.
And baby, he get to playing with the kids and everything else. And it was just funny because he coming out all white now. But at the end of the day, that white be brown. But yeah. It was always funny.
Now, listen to this. That was the first time at my family reunion. We used to go to Marlon. And I'm not going to tell you his name because everybody out there know him. And I just don't even want to do him like that. He done passed on at this point.
Which uncle was it?
I'm not going to tell you. Listen. I used to have an uncle
who was a drunk.
Oh, Lord.
And so to me, going to the family reunion meant I was going to get to see this man clown and act a fool every year, right? Because, you know, my mom was the one who had us dressed in the matching outfits and this, that, and the other. So right. we was coming to show out. But right. man, he was going to get drunk. He was going to pee. He was going to cuss somebody out. Wait. He was going to clown.
He was going to pee.
So to me, that was like one of the most memorable things, you know, that I can remember going through. We definitely had fun. We played all the games. That was when you got to see your cousins from out of town, no matter how big or small the country was.
They coming
we
from
was
everywhere.
All cousins that day. They was everywhere. We had fun no matter how far you moved away. I loved getting to see, you know, the different places that we were going to be. So
right. If
y'all haven't been having a family reunion, put your stuff together. It don't matter if it's 5 of y'all or 200 of y'all. Do something together this summer, okay?
And don't y'all be at the reunions fighting. I never seen that in my 50 years of living. We never had fights. We never had arguments.
And now we say, who making the potato salad? You. Go ahead.
But I heard a lot of stories how people get into it. Family members don't like this family or this person. And they get in fights. I'm like, man, I wish one of my family members would start fighting. I get a water hose and spray them like little dogs. What the hell y'all doing? But now we don't have that. We play dominoes. Now my uncles them and my cousin Santee, oh my God, they take them dominoes serious. Mm-hmm. But they don't get in no fights. They accuse each other of cheating. They accuse Uncle Claude of cheating sometimes. Somebody can't cop the money. Who gonna work the money? But it's very hilarious. We do volleyball, kickball. We have a lot of fun, but it's music. We just, you know, enjoy each other. Sit back and laugh.
Okay, so my next topic that I kind of wanted to talk about that was on the agenda was, you know, we ran across this. We were watching something on TV, and we ran across this topic, and we wanted to know, since we're talking about families, remember I asked, did you feel like you belonged as a kid? We've got a couple of people on here right now. When you were young, did you really feel like you fit in with your family? We talked about this amongst ourselves, but did you really feel like you belonged? Was there something personal that you had going on? Hey, Daryl, you remember me at them family reunions, hot and dirty, hair flying everywhere, messing up the family photos. Yeah, that's what.
Oh, my God. Family. I see some of her pictures. Everybody in there smiling, but this one here, and probably her brother too, they over there making all kind of faces and put the rabbit ears behind somebody's head, and she looking cockeyed and looking the opposite way.
I was holding a balloon in my teeth. No, maybe that was my cousin. I used to try to talk him into doing stuff too. We used to really have fun at those family reunions, man. That was lit, if you will. I was going to one too. Did you feel like you belonged as a kid? And I always felt like I belonged. I was, you know, I kind of felt like, you know, the cool kid in certain situations, but I definitely withdrew, you know, to myself at certain times. Did I feel like I fit with my family inside of my house? No, I always felt like the odd man out. My brother was everybody's baby. He was the loved kid. And you know, you can't compete with that. When you got that golden child, then it doesn't matter what they do. It don't matter how bad they are. Everybody love them. It don't matter what they do.
Well,
it just, you can't compete with that.
You used to be the golden child until he came along for those 7 years or five.
Six years. That six wasn't years. Very long. And I don't remember it.
Everybody loved Tania.
And I don't remember it. But no, I definitely think that people loved me. I think that people cared about me. But, you know, once he came along and started raising the roost, oh my gosh. But, you know, I guess all that points back to, you know, when we look at things and why things happen a certain way, you know, God knew he wasn't going to be here for very long. So everybody loved on him real hard while he was here. He was extra, extra bad, but he was fun. And that was my brother. And, you know,
and they have a lot of stories talking about him.
So did you feel like you fit in? You have a ton of brothers and sisters. I only had the one to deal with. Did you feel like you fit in with your family when you're growing up. And you guys, make sure you answer down in the comments, because I know that there's a ton of you guys in there who may or may not have felt like you fit in with your family. Did you, you know, there's some people who think I had to be adopted, you know, they, their older brothers and sisters tell them, we found you in a trash can, and here they are growing up believing they were really found in the trash can. People used to do that all the time. So did you feel like you, you did?
Okay. I was blessed. I had two families.
Okay, and you fit in with both?
Yes.
Okay.
I can go over here for the weekend, I go over here, but either way, yes, I felt that, hey, I was loved, I fit in, everything was good, but it came those times where I was responsible for all those kids. Now here it is, I got all these little cousins with me, plus along with my five siblings.
What's up, Brian? Happy birthday, boy. Hey, Ryan Wilson checking in. We are so happy that you are on here. We definitely wanted to link up yesterday, but we had three kids here and we didn't know how we was going to get them to the restaurant. Oh,
so we got two birthdays. Happy birthday, yes. B. And happy birthday, Big Rob.
All right, Big Rob's birthday is also today. We also want to say happy birthday to Dante, who just passed, Anthony's younger brother, who he say he fit
June
in with,
4th.
You know.
June 4th was his birthday.
So everybody out there in June, happy birthday. Father's Day is coming up, and y'all know that next week I'm definitely going to be giving you a list. I got to give you a list of Father's Day items that you could purchase. Don't forget the personalization, mom. Men love those little, you know, things with their names on it that they can feel like it's just theirs. Do not short them, ladies. Don't short them. You need to turn up on Father's Day just like you want them to turn up on Mother's Day.
Don't you bring me no socks, no ties, no drawers. I can go buy that myself. You give me something special, something nice, or take me to the four-wheeler park. You know,
oh,
I love
Lord
that.
Lord Jesus. We might have to figure out, we might have to scrap up some change so we can get back to the four-wheeler park.
They love it. We love
off-road
it.
Is always a good time. On, and I'm gonna shout them out because we have so much fun out there.
Yes.
Extreme Off-Road, where
Crosby.
Is that? In Crosby. It's always a really good time. They've got, you know, a wading pool or whatever, if you will, for the kids and family to hang out in, and the lake, if you want to come out there and have some fun. We may have to get out there one day.
Getting muddy again. You can barbecue, you can ride. Oh, don't let it rain, and then the road is just nasty. Now, somebody like to do stunts on their four-wheeler.
That's how I got these scars, y'all. Mm. I need to get my life together.
I don't do that. She has no regard for that four-wheeler, nor that hard-ass ground.
Now, earlier we were talking, I was talking just a little bit about Annual Underwear Affair and the event coming up. I need to talk to you guys about why Annual Underwear Affair is so important to us. We took time one time, you know, we always are having kids around us, and we talked to a little boy whose family could not afford the uniforms that are required by the schools and the undergarments to go underneath them, because a lot of people feel like, one, you know, it doesn't matter that you don't have underwear on. But please know, these children are out here spreading diseases and all different types of things for wearing the same undergarments too long. They're suffering from embarrassment. When it's time to dress out for PE, they can't dress out because they're scared that somebody's going to find them out. So that starts to work on your mental, if you will. Anthony, I know you also met a couple of our customers when we were asking for donations, because we are in the middle of our drive. We won't be giving away the items until July the 23rd. If you want to come out, lend a helping hand, we definitely would be happy to have you. If you DM me your email address, I can send you, okay? I can send you information on different ways that you can help. What you laughing at?
Somebody said, stop texting while you're on air. I can see you. Oh. I'm just sharing the... I'm just saying live.
Yes, because we need you guys to share, because we always have a really great message for you, and we want you guys to learn something. And this is a way that you can get involved and you can get your kids involved with giving. One of the customers, like I was saying, that Anthony met.
Adams Construction.
Not that one. What that one? We're going to shout out Adams Construction because he is our most dedicated giver.
What's up, Bo?
We are always receiving, you know, underwear through the mail from Bo Adams. Okay, so we had to make sure that he received a reward because we just love him. He was our big spender for 2021. We still have the opportunity for you to be the 2022 big participant, okay? So please make sure that you donate to us. Anthony's brother is pulling up.
I got to show him. He's a truck driver.
He is a truck driver. But we're not talking about that. We're talking about annual underwear affair. Jesus, this is serious. There's kids out there who need our help, and we want you to be a part of it. I know my husband don't take nothing serious, but this is really, really a serious matter.
I do.
We also met one of our customers who said his family was so poor that he probably didn't have his own pair of underwear until
he was in high school.
He was probably 12 years old, I think he told us. He was probably 12 years old, you know, when he starts functioning down there, if you will. So let's help prevent some of these kids from going through these challenges mentally by providing them undergarments. I know everybody likes to do the backpack giveaways with the school supplies and this, that, and the other. And we're fine for you to bring toiletries, toothbrushes, and things like this to go along with the backpacks or lip glosses that will help boost their self-esteem, because we're all about self-esteem as well.
Yeah, I know those kids when you were in PE that didn't want to dress out for class, and they might be one of those kids.
They may have been one of those kids. And there's so many families out there. You know, when I was growing up, it wasn't that we went without anything, but there were so many times I felt like if somebody would just help us or give us a lending hand, because my mom wasn't going to ask for anything. She wasn't going to accept anything, really, you know, honestly. Don't be that parent. You know, we understand that it costs, you know, a pack of undergarments to you may seem like nothing. It's only, you know, $10 or $15. It may not seem like anything to you, but there's a lot of people out here who cannot afford that $10 to be taken to the side.
So let's help those kids.
Very true. There are also tons of nurses and schools who need these undergarments as well for when girls have accidents at schools. Their parents aren't taking off. So they're leaving because they don't want to be embarrassed. And they need to be able to change undergarments so that they can stay healthy. Also, when it comes to these kids, y'all are already forcing them to play these sports. If they don't have clean socks to wear, they're spreading athlete's foot to the other kids. You know, I don't know if schools are still doing this, but I've even seen a website where kids are wearing old shoes that they have purchased online so that they can have the newest Jordan or the, you know, whatever like this, or retros. So when you're putting your foot in those shoes, if you don't have clean socks, that's a disease, a foot fungus that can hurt you, you know. So let's just try to help these kids out. Let's get out here. Let's be, you know, a blessing to the community, if you will.
To the kids. Help these kids, help these parents.
Yes. It says most of us have some of these kids in our own family, right? So that's the other thing, you know, in our community, pride is a huge thing. That's why I want it to be a free giveaway. I don't ask any names or anything like this because I don't want people to be embarrassed. All you have to do is come pick up your backpack with your size. It's gonna have undershirts for boys. Some boys had told us that they had never even had an undershirt. How are you dressing up to go anywhere? How are you feeling, you know, like you're warm in the winter time? You need an undershirt, you need underwear, you need socks, period, hands down. So we are also providing bras. That is one of the hardest things that I have time collecting, because bras are expensive. I have a really hard time, you know, and sometimes there are girl dads who are out here raising these girls and they haven't realized that girls, it's time for them to start moving into these bras. Mm-hmm. Who wants to have that conversation with their daughter that they're growing up and they're not their, you know, little baby anymore? And so it's easy sometimes for those guys to bring those girls up to me, and I'm gonna hand them what they need, period. I'm gonna look at them and see. Hands down, tell him to cut that truck off. Lord Jesus. You know, we were talking about being a trucking family, and y'all get it firsthand right here. Help us, Jesus. But anyway.
And Alice, you know who it is.
Let's talk about some other things real quick. Now, we know everybody's always, because you know I like talking about entertainers and entertainment news. So we're going to pop this in real quick. 50 Cent here in Houston, right?
Yes.
He's been giving to these schools. He's been doing an absolutely wonderful job. But guess what? I also heard, because you know I'm always keeping my ear to the street, Amari Hardwick did an interview.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to tell you who the interview was with, okay? He did an interview. I just need you guys to go on social media or go on to Fox Soul. You'll be able to see who he did the interview with. And he admitted he was barely getting paid to do power.
not Ghost.
He is still not making much money. He had to take a loan out from 50 Cent.
Ghost?
Come on. He is the staple of the show.
Yeah, he was.
So can you imagine how much the kids got paid?
I did not know that.
Maybe he likes the kids more, but let me say this. Is it 50 Cent's fault for not paying him what he feels like, well, we feel like he's worth, or is it his fault for not getting the contract straight?
His fault.
In the beginning. Okay, his I fault. Want you to talk about it real quick because his I need to fault. Go get my charge. Talk about it real quick.
There's no way that means, okay, so you're taking a contract. So it's just like doing a load or anything else, a contract and period, building a house or a job. It's all the same thing. If you feel as though this is not enough money for you, you need to try to renegotiate your contract or at least tell these people straight up, hey, I can't do it. That's not enough money in that for me. So you want me to be the star of this movie or this series? And you tell me I'm only going to make like $300 or $400 per episode? Nah, not even a couple $1,000s. You need to make way more than that. So yeah, you need to let these people know what you want. That's even in life. Somebody offer you something, say, hey, I'll pay you X, Y, and Z. If you feel like it's not what you're worth, you need to tell them no. And even in the relationship, it's the same thing. It's all the same. It's all about speaking up, saying what you want, what you don't want, what you like, what you don't like. I don't understand how this man can be the star of the show and he's barely making money or not making any money, because everybody loved Ghost. Ghost was the shiznit in this movie.
It's not a movie, it's a TV show.
Series, I said, episode. Because I was talking about how he need to renegotiate his contract or tell people, hey, no, I need more than that. Because I'm the star of this movie right here.
You know, a lot of us think that, you know, the story or the problem is just us, you know, that we're the only ones out there who are getting unfair treatment, who are this, that, and the other. And when you see somebody like that, that is on this grand platform that you think is doing amazing things and they still getting played, you realize that this is just kind of how things go, man. It's kind of how things go. So if you don't make it a point for your life to be different, it's going to be exactly that, okay? So he was saying that, you know, in some of these things, he said, Angela Bassett, so we're going to be very happy about this because it's a woman on top. Angela Bassett is one of the highest paid TV stars. I think she gets $250,000 per episode of, what is the name of that? I think it's called 911, the TV show that she's on. I don't watch it myself. I've seen a couple of episodes with my mother, but I don't watch it myself. But yeah, so she's the highest paid. I think he was getting more so around 150. And I know that sounds like a lot still to everybody else, but for a person of that caliber, I would think that, you know, they were getting paid out the wazoo to be doing these different types of shows and events. And now it's starting to make me think, what is he getting paid, you know, for these movies? And if 50 Cent is paying him that much for Power, which was on Starz, a huge platform, all of the rest of these movies that he's been in that are just kind of, you know, low rate budget, you know, indie films, how much is he getting paid for those? Something to think about, ladies and gentlemen. When your kids are out there saying they want to be an actor or actress, remember that it's very dirt dog game out in these streets, if you will. So let's also talk about, we got some stuff going on, Tevin Campbell. Oh, no. Let's talk about Snoop Dogg and Kim Kardashian. So a lot of people have been ragging on them because they took time out, you know, to kind of endorse, if you will, the candidate for mayor in LA. And everybody's all mad because he hasn't been standing up for, you know, African-American rights in a sense and all this other stuff. And I don't think that Snoop's was really an endorsement. He was just saying that what the guy was doing at the time was, you know, a good thing to be talking about. I mean, and so I don't know if his was, Kim K kind of did come out, but are people really running to the polls at her word? I don't know. I don't know if people are listening to Kim Kardashian when it comes to advice on who to vote for. And if you are, you might need to, you know, check your life. We know she about getting the dollar. So I would think that anybody who paid her would be able to get her endorsement.
Well, you know, these kids and these people out here, they listen to anybody that they think has a
platform
status or yes. But you need to do your own homework before you just vote or select somebody, because we say or they say this is the best person to be in office or to do whatever. No, you need to read up about them and find out before you start selecting them as governor, mayor, senator, or whatever. Because I'm quite sure they might not be standing for what you're standing for.
They may not, man. And if they're not, you better act like you know and figure something else out. While we're on that subject, ladies and gentlemen, this is I'm Just Saying Live. I'm glad that you checked in today. We are just having a live sit down, chill out talk. We're looking in the comments for any topics that you guys want to discuss. But while we're talking about that and we're talking about voting, remember that there is an election that is going to be coming up and you need to make sure that you're registered to vote. You know, I can't say this enough. I say this every time that there's something where you can register to vote. I'm all in for helping people register to vote. I've registered to vote my very first 18th after my 18th birthday. I made sure and I participate in the process. I suggest that you do the same.
Yeah, my grandparents made sure when I turned 18, you need to go down there and get your voter registration. I'm like, well, talk to my daddy. Say, yeah, you need to vote because every vote counts. And I'm like, okay. And I've been voting ever since.
Now, every week we have, you know, kind of been getting to where we're cutting it real close to the end of the show and we don't have time to talk about deals, touchy subject. We ain't doing that today, okay? Let's have a little bit of touchy subject. You right got now? One? I know he probably got one too, but we're going to have a little bit of a touchy subject and then we're going to get out of here. I just wanted to talk to y'all. Like I said, I just didn't want to leave everybody hanging, but I wasn't going to do a full show. And now we dang near done talked up time for a whole full show. I guess I'm still going to post it to Facebook Live so y'all can learn the stuff about the truck drivers, the ELD. We also want you to be able to comment on the Uvalde shooting. We also want you to be able to comment on all the things that we've talked about today. But right now.
Wait, before we do that.
Okay.
Well, also in your comments, make sure you tell us about your memorable moments at your family reunion.
Okay.
I need to see some of that stuff because I need to know. Because my family, they seem like they just ordinary people, but I love them. I don't get a chance to see the fights and the arguments or people falling in the barbecue pit and all that, catching a fire. And what she say? He at the family reunion drunk, peeing on everything.
You need some drinkers in your family.
They only drink at home and behind locked doors. But no, let us know so I can talk about y'all next week.
Okay.
Because I'm going to talk about you.
Here's this week's touchy subject, ladies and gentlemen.
Bum, 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 bum.
Bum, 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 bum. Okay. Listen. We're going to talk about somebody who has been in the limelight for years, okay? Ricky Williams.
What?
Yeah, I knew you would like that. What? I knew you would like that because we haven't talked any sports today.
Oh, my God.
Listen, Ricky. We're going to put him out there.
What are you doing now? Last time I seen him, he looked like a
all
roster.
Of the husbands. I'm sure that all of the husbands, you know, that's all on the camera. All of the husbands out there, I need you to chime in right now. I'm going to Facebook Live. I need to see your comments on this. It says on this post that I'm reading, it said, husbands can take our daddy last name. Listen, that's what it says. Former NFL player star Ricky Williams takes his wife's last name.
Oh, wait.
To create balance in the relationship.
How is that creating balance? I'm sorry.
Do we need, that's the point. I'm glad that you're saying that. Ladies and gentlemen, do you feel it appropriate for the woman to use her last name in a marriage? Let me say this. Y'all know I'm old school, traditional, however you want to put it. It may take you a little while to change your last name, but it is the ultimate disrespect unless you have talked to your husband, which they did. They came up to this agreement, but I still feel like you know that that's part of being married, that this man is giving you his last name. Not that all traditions are right, not, you know, that everything. Do you feel like it's okay to take the wife's last name?
Oh, you talking to me now?
Yes, I'm talking to everybody out there in La La Land.
You asking me? It's a sin.
Oh my.
It's a sin. I don't like that hyphen last name. So you gonna tell me you're gonna still keep your parents' last name or your daddy's last name? You're gonna hyphen it and then put my name with that? I don't even like that. So I'm old school. I don't know what the Bible says, but I know what traditionally we have been taught, that the woman gives up her last name to take my last name.
True.
No hyphen, no Young, it's just Thomas. So I might need to read my Bible and see what the Bible says, but still in all, no, I'm not going for it. And somebody needs to reach out to Ricky. Y'all know he down in Miami looking like a roster, getting full of that ganja.
That's what somebody said. That was like the main thing everybody was saying. You know what? That must be some real good stuff because there is no way. Men, this is your month. This is not only your month, but we have to include LGBTQ, IRX.
XYZ.
Yes, we need to also include that because, you know, who's to decide in those relationships what the last name is if there is not, you know, with women, a feminine and, you know, a male figure, how do we decide which last name even to go that, by now that they're getting married?
Well, even in that, it's one is the.
It's not always that way.
Well,
it's not always. Well, they get that married, way.
So somebody is more dominant than the other. But somebody's
so the dominant. So the dominance makes the factor.
I guess that's gonna make the man. Traditionally, the men are the dominant ones. We out hunting and working and whatever else. Not saying taking nothing from the woman. But I know I can be, you know.
You better clean it up then.
Did I clean it up?
You ain't cleaned it up at all.
Dominic, put in the headlock. Take this last name. Or get out of here.
All right, Travis. What's up, Travis? We was just talking about family reunions. Do you feel that it'd be right a man take the woman's last name? Ricky Williams out here getting dirty in these streets and taking on women's last names. And do we feel, how long we feel like these relationships gonna last?
I'm not taking no woman's last name.
And do you?
You can call me old. You
hey,
can call
Allison,
me,
how you doing?
You can call me whatever.
You can call me whatever. Well, that means that you should be okay with taking the last name.
I said you can call me whatever because I'm not taking the woman's last name.
Period.
Yes.
Okay.
Done.
I need you guys to comment. Somebody comment real quick on Facebook Live. I need to see what. Okay, it says it's whatever we decide as a couple, because we married, not us and the world. Don't give a ish what nobody think about who last name is taken. If they happy, that's all that matters. I mean, I'm definitely with that, but I feel like there is also a social structure that creates happiness, if you will, and allowing a man, like if you want to be happy in your relationship, because I know that there's a lot of women out here who are in these relationships that are not happy, and it's because you kind of don't want to go by the procedures. I know a lot of people talk about, hey, I'm going to start saying, you know, oh, here she goes. She supports the Kevin Samuels movement. I do, in a sense. You have to know what your person believes in. And no, you shouldn't get married if this person is feeling like they want to be having the last name. Then go marry somebody else. So I don't know. He says he's okay with it, so we can't be mad at their relationship, but we're talking about others out here. Should this even be something that was brought into play? I don't feel like it should have been brought into play.
Okay, so now you're saying what's the big deal behind it, and I'm not even talking about the tradition. It's just how we would talk.
Okay.
So, you know.
So, yes, and so we have another comment that says, do what works for you.
And that works for me.
That works for me.
Mrs. Thomas.
That part. I knew going into situations or whatever, that when you get married, you take on your husband's last name. That's where the lineage comes from. That's where the family dynamic comes from. Because now, here we are in confusion with the kids and where they fall on the family tree.
And let's talk about lineage. People be talking about it's from the mom and this and that. No, you need to do your research. Not taking nothing back from a woman, away from women, but the lineage is from the male.
Dun, dun, dun. This is I'm Just Saying Live. Ladies and gentlemen, we are discussing whether or not it's okay for men to take on the woman's last name. I think that this world has gotten so far from where we started that it's hard for a lot of people who are 40 and up to even figure what's going on right now.
Yeah, it's hard enough for me to work the computer. Okay,
you're so crazy. I just need y'all to post your comments. I also need you to like and share this show. I need you to support Annual Underwear Affair, and I still want to be able to give you affirmation for this week, okay? For you to live your life great. I want you to do wonderful things, but this is what I have to say to you today. Life will send you all the words your soul wants to hear, okay? You get that, Anthony? Life will send you all the words your soul wants to hear. If you are begging and pleading for something inside of your spirit, inside of your being, that's what's going to come your way. So definitely stay positive. Look toward those things that are going to be great. But what you were about to say?
Now, just because the earth, life gives you what you want to hear, what are you going to do with it when you hear it?
That part.
Are you going to act on it? Or are you just going to listen to it and do nothing? You can't get ahead by just doing nothing.
And trust and believe, it ain't always going to be what you wanted it to say. It's going to show you through all the things. It's going to remove people out of your life. It's going to do all these things. Life is going to do all those things. It's going to take you up. It's going to take you down. You can't control it, but you need to believe it when it happens and adjust, okay?
So don't be sitting there asking life to give you a new car, and then when life give you a...
You can't pay the note.
A Corolla.
You mad because you didn't want no Corolla. You wanted a Tesla.
Yeah.
God, that's life. That's life right there. So listen, life will send you all the words your soul wants to hear. So listen, remember going into this week to listen to yourself. Just do that for us.
Okay? Speak it into existence.
Speak it into existence. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, also, we watched the secrets of what is it called? Dumbledore. Secrets of Dumbledore. Kids are out of school. You need something to do. You know, I'm always giving you tips for that too. And that's what we're about to do. We're about to hit the swimming pool after I finish mowing this yard. Listen, The Secrets of Dumbledore, it was good. This one went to sleep on it. But it was good for the kids, okay? He was tired. We're just gonna say that he's always tired. But it's full of mystical creatures. I think that you guys would really, really like it. I hope that you've enjoyed today's show. I want to thank you for joining us right here on I'm Just Saying Live. I want you to remember, uplift those around you, because that's what we're going to do. And always try to support your community. We like doing that too.
I got one question before we go.
Okay.
So if the lineage comes from the man.
Lineage
comes from the man. Why do we call it Madea's family reunion? Why the family reunion is never the dad's last name?
It is the dad's last name.
Most of the time it's always about the grandmother.
No, it's not.
What's yours about?
It's the dad's last name. It's always the dad's last name. Because a mother doesn't have a last name.
I got it. But your
a mother doesn't have a last name.
Y'all family reunion? Y'all family reunion is what?
The dad's last name.
Would y'all be celebrating Madea?
No, we don't celebrate Madea.
Okay.
Those are families who don't have the granddad there anymore. Most of the time he's passed on before the grandmother. But the grandmother's name should be his last name.
Should be.
We should have brought this up during the subject. We got to go. I'll talk to him later because he clearly don't understand. That part, she was a hoe. I'm out. I don't want to end the show on that. Support your community, y'all. We love having a good time. We'll catch y'all next week.